Hey, Gixerman 01 back out in the garage. I'm shooting this intro after I've already done the work. So what I'm going to do in this video is replace this main shaft in my drill press. It's a porter cable drill press. I bought a mill vise, tried to mill some parts in it, pretty small parts, but the drill press is just not made to take side-to-side action. I knew better when I did it and did it anyway and paid the price. That's about $87 for a new shaft, I think is what I paid for it. After I bent the shaft in it, it was hard to drill anything accurately because the drill bits actually wobbled some as you was trying to drill something, so getting them started was a pain. Once you started drilling, it did okay, but it was hard to keep things on center. Going forward, I won't use this as a mill, but I will use it to accurately line up parts to drill with that vise. So I'm just going to walk through or just go through, tell you what you have to do to change the shaft. I probably should have shot video while I was actually changing it, but it's really simple. So I'll just walk you through it real quick right now. Okay, first thing you're going to do is you're going to have to take your chuck out. And so you'll have to go in here to get it. Actually, first thing you're going to do is unplug this thing. Okay, you're going to get right there. You're going to pop your chuck out by taking a punch and sliding it in there. You should be able to give it a little tap and that should pop your chuck out. Once you do that, you're going to take this piece off. There's an Allen bolt right here. Sorry, Allen bolt right there. Take that off. Slide the whole piece off. Take your nut off the top of it. Get that out of your way. Gonna take these two nuts off, pull this spring housing back very slowly. You're gonna make sure that you hold on to that washer. You don't want this thing just coming completely undone. There's a spring wound up in this thing, and you want to keep tension on it as you unwind it real slowly. Once you get it unwound and there's no tension on it, you should be able to slide it off. The spring goes through this little slot, and you're gonna slide this whole piece is going to slide out. Try to keep it as a complete unit if you can. It saved you a lot of hassle. I didn't, and I had to rewind it all, so it was kind of a pain. Once you've done that, you're going to be able to come over here. This whole shaft is going to come out, and it's going to let the whole shaft drop out, and you should end up with this piece right here coming out. The gear or the teeth on the back of it mesh into the teeth on your arm, and that's what holds it in. Put it back together. You're just going to reverse that process. It's not that difficult. I hope that anybody's wanting to take that out, they've got a bent shaft in their drill press like I did, about $87 to fix it. Don't use that as a mill and you won't have this problem. But anyway, that's how I took apart my drill press and replaced the shaft in it. I have probably 25 thousandths of wobble in that shaft, and now there's okay, so I replaced the main shaft in my drill press, and she runs pretty true now. There's a few thousandths of play. That could literally be just in the chuck itself and not necessarily in the shaft. But we were running about 22 to 25 thousandths back and forth on the chuck, and by the time you get that translated down to the drill bit, and my drill bits were just about wobbling when I was trying to drill anything, it made a ton of vibration. So that's why you don't use a mill vise to mill stuff in a normal drill press. They're just not made for that side-to-side pressure. So it's a little follow-up to my mill vise review. I guess this should have been my fix my drill press video. So thanks for watching. Please click like and subscribe. We'll see you in the next video.